Srinivasan is Chief Executive, Financial Services at the Aditya Birla Group. He joins us right now in the studio. Ajay, thanks very much. Thanks for dropping by. You were just telling me that the world is looking up. Is it looking up for the financial services industry as well?
Yeah, I mean, we're very much linked to the real world and to sentiments. At least half of that is changed. I think since Jan 1, some switch seems to have gone off, and markets are looking much more bullish.
What about, I mean, the business per se? I mean, you're pretty much into everything.
We're in a pretty broad range of products and services, very leveraged to capital markets in many ways. Mm. So I think it takes time. I think retail participation so far has been, I still think muted. Mm. But I think if this continues and the bullishness continues, then I think you will start seeing that coming back.
But that's just equity. What about other businesses?
I think fixed income is looking good as well, Prashant, because I think general view is that the interest rate cycle has peaked, and therefore you should see drops in interest rates, and that should be good for fixed income investors as well.
You're into commodity broking as
yes.
well?
Yes. So in our broking business, we do equity, both cash and F&O, and of course commodity, and we've done well in that.
What about the asset management side of the business? You were just talking about how, there's not been an actual pullout of money, but that still caused a little bit of a stress point for you this time.
No, I think for the quarter ended December, at least, we had some outflow due to bank AUM, leaving the system. So the industry as a whole faced some outflows in the fixed income category. I think on equities, it was more mark to market, which was, more than come back, with this bounce back.
What's the overall growth in terms of, the book as a whole?
So if I give you the numbers for the quarter ended December, we had revenues for the quarter itself of about 1,558 crores, which was up about 7% over the similar quarter last year. If I do year to date, revenue was about 4,570 crores, which was up about 5% year to date previous year. But I think what has been more interesting is our profitability, because our profitability year to date was about 453 crores, which is up about 48% over the previous year. So I think our focus has been in a market which has had reasonable challenges from a sentiment.
So where is this coming from?
So the profitability is coming across the board. Our life insurance business is a big contributor to profitability. Our asset management business is profitable. Our NBFC has been a big contributor to the delta in profits over the quarter. All our businesses are contributing.
But that's not sizable enough, NBFC.
Our NBFC is now getting to a stage where it's a reasonable size. We grew our asset book by about 86% December over December. So I think now we're getting to a stage where at least we're starting to be a reasonable size player.
You're completely leveraged. I mean, most financial firms are to the real economy.
And, yes.
Where is the growth going to come from for you? I mean, you're into pretty much everything: asset management, life, equities, broking, NBFC, lending. I mean, where do you see the opportunity from here out?
See, I think the big opportunity, Prashant, is still the fact that India may slow down, but it still grows 6.5-7%. If you take a 30% savings rate on that, there's a significant pool of savings that's coming in every year. I think what we've seen over the last year, some of that savings has moved into physical assets. So we've seen gold, real estate kind of...
The RBI data, for example, shows
on gold.
Gold and, equities as well. I mean,
yes.
Equity investment as a percentage of household savings is probably the lowest.
Yes.
Since the last two decades or something.
Absolutely. So, I think you need some sustained move, in markets, some improvement in sentiment, and some sense of the relative economic growth of India relative to the rest of the markets. It's all going to ultimately be an asset allocation game, Prashant, as it's happened in many other markets. Ultimately, people will realize that keeping your money in fixed deposits, in assets that post-tax, post-inflation don't give you the return that you need, is not going to be the way to build your financial future. I think those changes in asset allocation, which is a slightly long-drawn process, I think that's what will lead to growth in all the products and
services.
And
you're in it for the long haul, in all
Absolutely.
These businesses.
I mean, we are really geared to the growth in savings and the underlying growth of the Indian economy. And, that seems to be a good trend.
Retail as a part of your book is also a significant chunk,
yes.
but participation has been a little dry there.
Yeah, we have about 6 million customers across our portfolio, and they're a large segment across all our businesses. I think last quarter was clearly, as I said, there were enough headwinds in terms of sentiment and capital markets. So you do see some muted participation. But that always picks up. I think once sentiment changes and once the markets pick up, you see the retail participation coming back.
What's your view on the real economy, Ajay? I know you track that closely as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think growth is
real economy at the financial markets. I mean,
yeah, I think growth is clearly slowing down, Prashant. I think I'm personally most concerned about the investment cycle. I think this big slowdown in investments, that will take time to turn. It's not just a function of interest rates. Interest rates have to come down, but I think it's also a function of sentiment. And I think till you can start seeing the investment cycle picking up, I don't think you're going to start seeing growth rates that we kind of got used to, you know, 3-4 years ago. I think consumption will take us up to a point. Services growth will take us up to a point. But you need manufacturing and you need investments to kickstart again.
But do you believe that, growth rates have kind of bottomed out?
I think they may have bottomed out, but I think it'll be a while before you start seeing them pick up, because I think you will see some move from consumption, but you do need investment to pick up if you're going to start seeing GDP growth.
And you don't see that coming back soon?
I don't see it in a hurry. I think, as I said, interest rates have to come down, and I think sentiment has to improve. I think that's when you'll start.
Do you think RBI will ease significantly this year?
I think the RBI will be constrained by what happens on the fiscal. And I think the RBI has constantly mentioned that in all their policy documents, that monetary policy can do its job up to a point in time, but the fiscal does have to keep pace. And I think the fiscal deficit is something that we
so
need to watch.
So you're not watching out for a big rate cut.
No,
someone is calling for 200, 300 basis point rate cut.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a function of where inflation goes and where the fiscal will end, Prashant. I think those two will be important.
For a business like yours, interest rates is very important.
Yeah, I think business like ours, interest rates falling is always a good sign.
All right.
Ajay, thanks very much.
Thank you
for your time.
Thank
Hope
you.
To see more of you on the real economy and financial markets as
sure.
well.
Thank
There's
you.
A couple of floors down, right?
Up.
Up. Yeah, thanks very much.
Thanks.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.